Peter Della Penna here with West Indies Under-19 head coach Roddy Estwick after a four-match series sweep over the USA Under-19 squad. Congratulations, first off, on that, coach. What is your overall assessment of how things turned out this week?
Well, it turned out really wonderful. It's what we set out to do. Obviously, we weren't too concerned about the opposition. We knew what we wanted to do, and we were able to execute it. Every time we've asked the boys to, we've raised the bar, we've asked them to go a little higher, go a little harder, and they've achieved that from scoring 278 on the first day to scoring 369 in the third game, really proved where we were at in terms of our development and moving on and pushing forward. So we're very, very happy.
Now, after the second day, you were hoping to try and push for 400 and keep U.S. under 60. You didn't get to those targets, but you had some very impressive performances at that point in time. You said 70% is what you thought the team was performing at. Did the team get to 100% or?
No, we were nowhere near 100% because even when we got 330 odd, there was still 128 not balls. So that's an area of concern to me, because once the standard gets a little bit higher and go into bigger competitions, you can't really allow so many dot balls. So that's something that we've got to work on. We've got to minimize those dot balls. If we can bring those dot balls down to between 40 and 50, then I would think that we'd be near 100%, but we're still dropping catches as well, you know, so we're still bowling. The extras have top scored in two of the games, so those are areas, so we're nowhere near 100%.
John Campbell was the leading run scorer for your team in the series. The first day he scored a century, the second day he scored a century, his first century in the series, he had several drop chances, but the second two centuries, he batted much more efficiently and really kept the USA bowlers under pressure the entire time. What was your overall feeling on how he progressed from day two to day three and four?
Well, I'm very, very happy. The management team are very, very happy with John's performance, because John's been around the under-19s for a number of years, along with Craig Bradford. They're the only two people returning to the World Cup. So we are happy that he's got a score. He's never really had any centuries before for the West Indies under-19, so we're quite happy. But what I've liked about him, and especially in the last two innings, that he was really able to construct his innings. Even though he played the big shots, he was able to play the delicate shots as well. He didn't hit the ball in the air as much as he did in the first 100, and he didn't give as many chances as well.
Your pace bowlers on the first 2 days bowled terrific, but on the second 2 days in particular, you had two left-arm spinners and then two leg spinners who really, really kept USA from turning over the strike, getting any singles, really keeping the pressure on them. Why were they able to be so successful?
Well, obviously they're very good bowlers. They're going to be very important to us moving forward. Kiani from Guyana, who didn't get here until the first game was played. He's played first class cricket, so he's obviously one for the future that we're looking at. So we're quite happy with where the spinners have gone. We're quite happy with the bowling unit. You know, the biggest worry coming into this tournament was the batting, but the batting has really stood up and people have got a hit, and we're very, very, very happy.
You've got just about a year to go until the Under-19 World Cup in Australia. What do you have set up for the next 12 months, and where do you go from here, and what are you going to do to, what is being organized to help sustain the high level and the high standards that this team has demonstrated here?
Well, obviously on Saturday they go off to play in the Under-19 tournament in Guyana, so they all go in there. Then they come back after the tournament is finished, they have a 2 weeks camp in Barbados at the High Performance Center. After that, they go to the 50-over tournament, the regional 50-over tournament as a unit, which will be a very good experience for them, because they'll be playing against all the top players in the region. So that'll be good for us. And then it's in the pipeline that we might be going back to Dubai over the Christmas period as well, to play against Pakistan and India. So that'll be a good challenge for us as well, because they would bring something totally different from what Australia brought in terms of the slow bowling and the way they played slow bowling as well. So we're looking forward to that as well, and hopefully, you know, then we should know where we are after December in terms of playing those two teams.
What's going to be the key to, over the next 12 months, trying to win the Under-19 World Cup?
Everybody staying focused. Obviously, it's a long trip. You go up to Australia, we have 4 months, people get homesick. If we can stay as a unit, like we have over the last couple of tours that we had, then I don't foresee a problem. The talent is there. Once we stay together, once we put the team first, and everybody should have their individual goals, but the team goals is more important. If you put the team first, you've got more chance of winning games than losing.
All right, West Indies Under-19 head coach Roddy Estwick, congratulations again. Thanks a lot for your time.
Pleasure, thank you.